No, your father just...
My dad's in here, but I don't remember.
I know your mom had to go to the bathroom.
What's up, man?
Good. You're the reason I drink it, to be honest.
I'm a dirgeon.
This. You can do that too, actually, okay. Angela. Alright. Annie, put your hand on Ray.
Wait.
Yeah.
Boop. Boop. No way you got a mole.
Oh my god, congrats!
Thank you!
Blowing all their info.
You said you can't hide it anymore, you
yeah.
can't.
What's going on?
Yeah, I'm trying.
I don't know. What are we talking about? It's a video.
Oh! Wait, what are you? Thanks for telling me!
Thank you.
I'm so fine, I'm so fine.
don't know me, I'm Julia. I'm Ray's sister. When Annie first asked me to make a speech, obviously I told her no. But then she said I didn't have a choice, so here I am. Don't worry though, I'm gonna keep this short and sweet. I just want to start off by saying congrats, Annie and Ray. I love you both so much, and I'm so happy for you. I don't even remember when these two started dating, but I do remember the first time I hung out with them. I was about 17 years old, and Ray took me and Annie out to eat. When she got up to go to the bathroom, I asked Ray, is this like a serious thing or something? And he laughed, and he said, yeah. And then I said, do you love her? And he said, yeah, I really do. Little did I know that after that, Annie would become a huge part of our lives, but most especially mine. She has been by my side through everything. She sat in the back seat of my brother's car while I learned how to parallel park. She was with me when I got ready for my prom. She has been to all of my birthdays. She picked me up at the bar at 2 o'clock in the morning so I could bail my best friend out of jail. And I even smoked my very first cigarette with her. Sorry, Mom and Dad. I'm so grateful that I got to grow up with Ray. He taught me how to wrestle. He told me that Santa Claus was not real.
Nice job, Ray.
He sold me marijuana. And he bought all of my alcohol for me when I was in high school. What a horrible brother. I had such an amazing childhood, and Ray was a huge part of that. One of my favorite memories with him is that almost every Christmas morning, he would wake up early and he would come lay on the floor of my bedroom and we would talk about what we thought our presents would be until our parents woke up. I know it's something so simple, but it is one of the reasons that Christmas is my favorite holiday. I knew this day would come, so when I was about 12 years old, I wrote a sentence in the back of my diary so I would remember to put it in my speech. Here it is. It was nice growing up with someone like you. Someone to lean on, someone to count on, but most of all, someone to tell on. Annie, I'm so glad that my brother found you. You are one of my best friends, and I'm so thankful that I get to have you in my life. I love you like a sister, and I can't wait to spend the rest of my life annoying you and Ray. Ray, I love you more than life. You and JC are the two halves of my heart. There is no kind of love like the one you get from your brothers, and I feel sorry for anyone who doesn't have what we have. I'm so happy you found the one. I wish you and Annie nothing but the best. JC, good luck finding a future wife because she has some big shoes to fill. Thank you, everyone, and let's hear it for the Ramoses.
One more time for Romeo, guys. Check, 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 check. How's everybody doing? You guys good? Yeah. All right, Ray, don't worry. I'm not going to let out any secrets. I'm not going to talk about beach week. I'm just going to keep it simple. First of all, I just want to say thank you for the honor to stand by you on your big day. Congratulations. Ray and I go way back. I met Ray when I first came to this country 18 years ago, and he was the best friend that any immigrant could have, just always been there with me, just introducing me to new people and new friends, and just the American way of living. So I just want to thank you for that. Over the years, we had a special friendship. I feel like we're different in a lot of ways, but in many ways, we're similar. We have the same love for music. We both love sports. We both love the Eagles. Go Bears.
Woo-hoo! Yes, sir! Yes, sir! We played basketball together at George Wolf Elementary School. We went on to play basketball at middle school. We didn't play that much, so that kind of that kind of killed our dreams of basketball. We didn't try out in high school. We kind of cut it short there, but we did do well at football in middle school. Our middle school football team went 17-0. So if I can get a little hand clap for that. But we had a lot of great memories together growing up. I know now as we are growing into an adult, life gets in the way. We get busy. We don't really have time to do the things that we used to. But Ray's always there for me. I'm a DJ, and every time I call Ray, he comes and he's my MC. So I really appreciate that we're still keeping the friendship. We check up on each other here and there, and I'm really grateful for that, that you're always there for me. And Annie, I just want to say, you got a great man here. He's gonna always be there for you. He's always been there for me. So I just want to wish you guys the best. I don't have a drink right now, but let's toast to the new Mr. and Mrs.
Big shoes to fill here. So first off, I'd like to thank everyone for coming today.
Yeah.
To celebrate their marriage. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Troy. I'm one of Ray's best men. When Ray asked me to be his best man, I was honored and also very nervous, as you can see right now. I'm not the best at speeches, so you guys will definitely all make it out of this alive. I know that. Ray and I became friends in school and on the football field. We've been friends for over 10 years now. Trust me, I tried to get rid of him a few times, but I can't hold him underwater longer than he could hold his breath. As we all know, Ray is a very talented individual. He has the voice of an angel, and he's absolutely shredded on the guitar. Ray's favorite dinosaur is Velociraptor, also mine. He has a great smile, long, majestic hair, see, longer than my past relationship, by the way. When Annie and Ray are together, I'm normally the third wheel, but she makes it feel okay. And that's because I'm single. It's not by choice, it's by the choice of other women in my life. Being Ray's friend for so long, I found out that he's absolutely terrified of flying trampolines because one smashed into his car while he was driving. He's also not too fond of spiders after one bit his face in Tennessee. He did not turn into Superman or Spider-Man like I hoped, actually. But his face did swell up, so at his expense, I got a few laughs out of him. All jokes aside, Ray is one of the best friends I could ever ask for, and I'm grateful we met and shared all the experiences. The most memorable experience that we shared together would have to be the Friends weekend at my cabin, where we bonded. We went spotting at night, hiking through the woods, and let some lead fly down range. And I believe after that, you bought a pistol. If I'm not mistaken, after that weekend. Annie, you look absolutely stunning. Let's give it up for the bride. I'd like to welcome you to the family, but you've been family for so long now, so I don't think I need to. And you're also so very talented, and you bring such a good vibe wherever you go. I love when I get to see your paintings and that you find happiness in your art. I know that both of you will be great parents if you have kids one day, and they will be both talented as you are. I know that you guys will take great care of each other. I know he will, and I know you will. I love the both of you, and I cannot wait to see what your future brings. So with that being said, I'd like to propose a toast to Annie and Ray, the beautiful couple.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, one more time, put your hands together for our best man, Troy.